Okay, here we are today with Miss Linda and Miss Carla at the YouTube Hair Salon. Miss Linda is in the chair and Miss Carla is washing her hair. They're both natural hair specialists.
So what I'm doing is I am totally saturating her scalp. Her hair is very, very thick. So you can't just run water on the top of it because it won't get all the way down to her scalp. I'm making sure you get it all the way down to her scalp. So when I get ready to put her shampoo on, I have enough moisture all the way down to work up a good lather and cleanse both her hair and her scalp. Just kind of working it around the top and the bottom. Feel that dread right there. So I take the shampoo and I get it emulsified in my hands and then kind of work it through her hair to make sure I get it on before I start massaging and manipulating her scalp so we can work it through. So right here in the front is where you people get really itchy, and right in that crown, we're finding a lot of African-American women are getting an itch spot right in that little area. But I start at the hairline and work that. Get a little more shampoo on her hair. And we do a very vigorous shampoo here, so. And then work from the front and just go back. And I have my fingertips all the way, the balls of my fingers, all the way to her scalp through her hair. That first shampoo is what breaks that dirt up and loosens it up. Sometimes when you shampoo the first time and you notice that you don't get a lather, it's okay, because it's actually that initial breaking through that dirt. Loosen it up. That second shampoo will allow you to get it all off the scalp. Make sure you get under that, back here at that nape. People kind of forget that area. It's very important to note the stimulation that you'll feel on the scalp. It really helps to increase the blood flow. And we know that blood is what feeds the hair follicle. It's going to really help you to get a healthy head of hair when you manipulate that in the right way. So very, very important. So make sure you're not scratching the scalp where you could damage it with your fingernail. But using those soft nibs, those fatty pads of your fingertips to really help get in a massage. And it helps to loosen the scalp up, because sometimes you can have a scalp that's very tight and it's hard for the hair to really get nourished, the follicle of the hair to really get nourished. So you really want to massage that scalp very, very good.
Now when you say tight, can you further elaborate with that?
Well, depending on how much you comb your hair, being natural, or brush your scalp or manipulate your scalp, sometimes what can happen is if your hair is not used to that that stimulation, your scalp, the skin on your scalp can become tight and it will constrict. And a lot of people who have what we call tender heads, sometimes it's because their scalp is so tight, so that pulling is very painful. When you go to comb it or to any type of manipulation, it's very, very painful. But just like the muscles in the rest of your body, you have muscles underneath your scalp. And by massaging and gently massaging those and using warm water, you can loosen those muscles up. And then that, in turn, will then help nutrients to flow to your scalp and blood flow to get to your follicles.
You can feel in somebody's, for me, it's like feeling the skin of a tangerine.
Yeah.
That's really taut and tight. And when it loosens up, it's almost feeling the softness of a banana.
Yeah.
It moves.
And then you'll also feel that scalp move. Because when it's very tight, you won't get very much movement of the skin on the scalp. And once you loosen that up, it's really a lot more pliable. Okay. And it feels great.
Whatever y'all using, it smells great. It just seems like your hair. I'm wishing I was getting my hair washed right now. It's like it seems peaceful.
Make sure when you're rinsing that you rinse all the residue of the shampoo, conditioners, out. And with natural hair, you can't rinse and shampoo our hair like running through a car wash. I mean, you know, you got to get in there, separate, make sure that water's, you know, I always have, when I do like this and I can see that water to the front, see that water coming to the front of that scalp, mm-hmm. I know that I'm cleansing all that scalp area. If it wasn't, that water wouldn't come. Yeah, I'm sure we've all had our hair shampooed and you got about the bowl and it felt like it was so dirty. Oh, that's enough to make you mad.
And because when you have natural hair, you're not shampooing your hair every day. You know, once a week, maybe every other week, and maybe sometimes every 3 to 4 weeks, depending on what style you're using and what your hair, very individual. So you really want to make sure that you're getting a good cleansing when you do cleanse. That initial shampoo, a couple of shampoos should be, you know, really cleansing, and then following in with moisture. It's going to make all the difference in the world. A good moisturizing shampoo. First a good cleansing and then a good moisturizing shampoo.
This is conditioner, but I'm still massaging the scalp while I'm working the conditioner.
I'm sure we'll get it back.
Oh, right.